And we've had a lot of callers who've approached this program with negative feelings.
Mm.
Do you remember Nicole, who gave us a spray?
Vaguely.
So you got that there, Gracie?
List the complaints.
You guys are so pathetic sometimes.
Yeah.
The things you say, you just go on and on about it, and it is really, really stupid.
And shouting, we always shouting.
And I hate your voices, they're so annoying.
I hate your voices, they're so annoying.
Nicole, you know what I reckon? I reckon you've just got to be honest with yourself and admit you're in love with the both of us. And you want nothing more than to be caught in a Martin Molloy sandwich. Nicole, I'm sensing the negative vibe.
You are so true. That is so true, you know. I really am. Just want to get into your pants and just...
Well, come in. There's plenty of room.
Them's big tracky decks and you're invited.
There's a bloke, he stands out the front going, hey, you want to come into Mixed Tracky Dacks? Come in now, first drink for free.
I don't like it.
Even that really annoys me, you know, because I'll tell you one reason.
Okay.
You go on and on about it.
Okay.
So you put her on all the time. Can't you just put something
I don't
else
like
on?
It.
Nah.
Can you
I don't like it.
Shut up, really.
I don't like it.
We got plenty more where that came from,
can
Nicole. We're prepared to play this all day.
I don't like it.
Give her another one,
like
Gracie.
It.
Keep them coming.
I don't like Pepper it.
Pepper around the ears. Strafe Nicole with I don't like it.
I don't like it.
Hey, you. Hey, you going to back down?
I don't like it.
You know, this is the final call.
Oh, righty,
yeah. For I don't like it, so I'm sure you've got something big to get angry about. What is it?
The Commonwealth telephone banking ad with Amanda Keller.
With Amanda Keller, yes, we've seen that.
Her cardigan.
I don't like it.
There's the big finale we've been waiting for.
It's a shocker.
Can you describe the cardi?
Like the colours is just what strikes me. It's like these beautiful browns and yellows and blues and those big buttons on it and the different collar colour and then...
Yeah. But it's the Commonwealth Bank. It's been tailored to suit her needs. What's the daggiest thing you've done?
We had a party one night and my girlfriend at the time crashed out, so I shaved both of her eyebrows off.
What happened when she woke up?
Well, she didn't know, and then that was the next morning. She cleaned the whole house up, which was really good, so I got all that in. It wasn't until then she discovered that both her eyebrows were missing. She hit the roof.
Yeah, and she was quite surprised, but you couldn't tell.
I've got some friends that got married on a golf course, and what they did was they hit off on the 18th together.
Right.
They played the hole out before they got married.
Right.
And they had their vows after they putted out.
Yeah.
Then they both jumped into the little golf cart and went for a wheelie around the golf course.
Fantastic. And the priest, was he involved? Was he caddying?
No, not quite.
Yeah, I know some people who didn't take their marriage as seriously as that and they had a mini golf wedding. That's when you know it's not going to last.
It all fell apart. Right about the windmill.
What are you wearing?
Well, I don't have them on now, but I've got a pair of black edible G-strings.
Oh,
edible G-strings.
What flavour that's right?
It's chocolatey.
Yeah, but before you wore them, what flavour?
And I've got different colours, red and white, and I've got one pair that's got Bite Me on the front.
Oh, all those. She's got eyes bigger than her stomach.
Yeah. Don't go swimming for at least an hour after you've woofed your undies. Do you know, this is something I only heard today. Apparently, Mario Milano used to wrestle in edible trunks.
I know.
Didn't you know that?
He was the erotic rock and roll wrestler.
She's got this habit of keeping herself amused by turning the TV on and off. And, of course, it develops a nice bit of static charge on the tube.
Yeah.
So she puts her head up against it and it pulls her hair out. And that, and sort of from her head, so it sticks out.
I watched Good Morning Australia with Bert, and if I turn the telly on and off really fast, his hair starts to rise.
It's true. What have you done?
I'm the editor of our student newspaper.
George, are you corrupt?
No.
Okay,
you'll learn.
And we had a couple of extra, you know, spaces on one of our pages one day, so I did 12 lines of I Love Simon, I Love Simon, I Love Simon.
And you're still together today?
Yeah.
That's good because you would have had to have done a We Were Wrong.
I have a friend of mine who I went to with at primary school and also high school on TAFE. Now, his problem was he used to touch people's ears.
That's why Michael Bolton released Don't Touch Me There. It's that bloke chased him around, going his ear all day.
Now he's done a sequel called Don't Touch Me Hair, isn't he?
Did Michael Bolton do Don't Touch Me There?
Was that it? What's the song?
I don't know, but
Touch Me There, what is it? I want to touch you there.
No, don't touch me. Don't cross me on Michael Bolton. I've got the anthology at home. You'll do better, my friend, than to cross me. Wasn't it don't touch me there? Oh, no, I'm...
Who cares?
No, I'm get on with what's it. His name? Don't touch me, boy.
You're thinking of Paul Mercurio.
Paul Mercurio's new album. Don't touch me, boy.
Do you remember that amazing revelation that came out about the 40s band leader Glenn Miller?
Yes.
Who is believed to have died...
he was going about the biz.
Oh, should we say it with music?
Let's do that.
Let's say it with music.
Job in the nude, up the spout. Glenn Miller with a prostitute in Paris in the nude, on the tool, hammer and tongs. Tim Parrish in a plane crash as suspected on the job.
Mickey in the nude,
Gracie
up the spout.
Sancia.
Glenn Miller with the prostitute in Paris.
In the nude.
Everybody!
On the tool.
People at home!
Hammer and tongs.
You in cars!
Sid Parrish in a plane crash as suspected.
This is Martin Molloy.
Marvellous.